helping you achieve your financial goals and dreams, $1,000 at a time. Hi everyone, welcome back to Sugar Mama TV. I am financial planner Kanna Campbell. I really hope that all these videos that I'm making for you on YouTube and of course Instagram through IGTV are really helping create a shift and a breakthrough when it comes to achieving your financial goals and dreams. And you are realizing how powerful and how capable you really are. Today, I want to talk to you about the $1,000 project, remind you as to what it is all about, why I started it, why it works, and show you exactly how to do your own $1,000 project so you can really add some additional efficiency, mindfulness, and excitement when it comes to achieving your own financial goals and dreams. First of all, what is the $1,000 project? All right, this was a fun financial challenge that I set for myself over 5 years ago on YouTube when I first launched. I took one really big, scary, overwhelming financial goal and just simply broke it down into bite-sized, mini, manageable, and achievable mini financial goals of $1,000 at a time. Now, I set this challenge up and put myself out there, which was really scary at the time, for 3 reasons. Number one, I wanted people to realize that we are not dictated by how much we earn from our 9-to-5 salaries. We all have the ability to bring in some extra money in our lives outside of our jobs. We can take on some extra work over the weekends. There are things we can sell. We can do online surveys and market research. We can do babysitting. We can do dog walking. We can do house sitting. We can start our own little mini businesses outside as a side hustle. I was sick of hearing people say to me, well, I only earn this much money per year. I can never go and, you know, start investing or pay off that debt or own my own home. I wanted to really like crush that idea because it's just crazy and only self-limiting. The second reason I started the $1,000 project is I wanted people to realize that when you proactively and mindfully and responsibly move money towards your financial goal and remove temptation and distractions, it really helps you achieve your financial goals and dreams more efficiently. And then the third reason why I started the $1,000 project is I wanted to educate people around investing and, more importantly, educate people around the importance of passive income streams. Because when you earn passive income, that is your money working for you rather than you working for money. So, for example, it's earning interest off a savings account. It's earning rent from an investment property. It's earning dividends from your share portfolio. And of course, the more passive income that we have in our life, the less financial stress we have in our lives. So there were the 3 reasons why I set the $1,000 project up. Now, you can do the $1,000 project for yourself. You can do it to achieve mini goals, such as like getting rid of pesky credit card debt that's been haunting you for a while. And you can achieve it for big picture goals and dreams, such as paying for your first home or paying off your home, or even investing and planning a really early retirement, whatever it may be. The $1,000 project evolves with you. You have complete control. You set the rules, you set the boundaries, but you actually see and feel progress along the way, which is why it works, because you are motivated by seeing the progress, seeing the shift, seeing how quickly and easily money adds up over time. What are the 7 steps to do the $1,000 project for yourself? All right, it's really easy and it's really fun, I promise you. Number one, come up with just one simple financial goal. But this financial goal must excite you. You must feel empowered, you must feel motivated, you must feel inspired. It just has to be one financial goal. I recommend picking a financial goal that's going to immediately alleviate financial stress in your life. So, for example, if you are someone who has credit card debt, this is a great financial goal to use the $1,000 project for. However, it really is up to you. Just make sure you feel excited and motivated. Step number two is to open up a separate dedicated savings account for this financial goal. The reason why you must have a separate dedicated savings account is because we need to separate the money that we create, save, earn, manifest from doing the $1,000 project and put it into a separate savings account so that we can see what is actually working, what works best, what do we need to tweak and change, and we can see this money actually adding up. Also, by having this money in a separate dedicated savings account, you won't accidentally spend it and you won't get tempted to spend it because this money is going to be safe. It's quarantined, it's stuck here until you are ready to tick off achieving that financial goal and dream. The third step is to nickname that separate dedicated savings account. Now you can choose two different nicknames if you like. Number one is you name it the $1,000 project account or my $1,000 project account. The second nickname that you could choose is in relation to your financial goal. So for example, you could call it my credit card debt reduction goal. Whatever it is, it must be either the $1,000 project must be in the nickname or it must be named towards your financial goal. Why is this? Well, very easy. It keeps you focused. It keeps you motivated. It reminds you as to what that money is for. So if temptation or distraction ever comes your way and you look at your accounts online, which I recommend you do every day to remind yourself, you are reminded as to what that money is for and what you're working towards. And also by seeing this money in relation to your goal, you're realizing that every day you are one step closer to achieving that goal. Step number four is to look at ways to create more savings in your life and create more earnings in your life. It is where you start by looking at your budget and you have a really open, honest conversation with your life as to where your living expenses are at, how they all add up, and what changes you can make where you either reduce temporarily or permanently or cut out completely some of your lifestyle living expenses that don't add value in your life. For example, I might look at my life and go, well, you know what, if I started taking my lunch to work during the week, I might save, say, $60. And I might look at my lifestyle and maybe cut down as many social activities. Instead of going to, you know, a bar or a restaurant every single weekend, I'll go, say, 3 weekends of every month. And the money that I save from that will help go towards a $1,000 project. But also, whilst we look at savings in our life and cutting down and mindfully managing our budgets with more respect and balance, we also look at ways that we can bring in some extra money in our lives. So this is where you grab a paper and a pen and write down as many ideas as possible that you can earn some extra money. Are there things that you can sell? Is there some babysitting work that you can do? Is there some dog walking or some houseworking or some house sitting? Can you look at a promotion? Can you look at a new job? Can you ask for a pay rise? What are all the things that you can do in your life, and nothing is crazy, that you can help bring in some extra money in your life that you can put towards your financial goals and dreams? There are no limits, and you don't have to do all of them at the same time. You might pick and choose ones that are really easy and really accessible and achievable right now, but make sure you do something rather than nothing at all, because this is what's going to create a shift. And I'll tell you this, when you start brainstorming, it's amazing all the different ideas and opportunities that you start realizing exist around you. Step number five now involves using those savings and earnings in a proactive way. So this is what I call proactive transfers. So for example, if I take that idea of me taking my lunch to work every day and saving, say, $60 between the Monday to Friday, what I would do either at the end of each day or at the end of the week, I would then go and transfer that $60 in savings to my dedicated savings account, nicknamed my $1,000 project account. Now, by doing this, I'm actually removing temptation and putting that money into that goal. You see, it's so often we save money all the time, but that savings evaporates because we then use those savings towards another expense. We get to the end of the week going, well, I tried all these things to save money, but I'm still don't have any money left. This is why this strategy works, the proactive transfer, removing that money. So it's like you spent that money already, but you've actually shifted it over here where it's quarantined, it's safe, and you can see that money, see those savings, see those extra, you know, earnings really add up. Step number six is the fun part. The moment your savings hits $1,000, that is where you will do something towards achieving your goal. So, for example, say you have $5,000 in credit card debt and your goal for the $1,000 project is to pay this off. The moment the savings hits $1,000 in that separate savings account, you transfer it onto the credit card debt. You also make a note that your $5,000 credit card debt is now down to $4,000. Now, there is one slight change if you're using the $1,000 project to save up for something like, you know, a deposit for your first home. You don't need to transfer that money anywhere else unless, of course, you want to change it to a different savings account. But you can keep this $1,000 in this account until you have your deposit money. You can use this as your proper savings account for this goal. But ideally, if you're using it for debt or you're using it for investing, make sure you transfer that money the moment you hit $1,000. And of course, you take the time to acknowledge, write down, and track the progress that you're making. So every time you hit $1,000 more towards your deposit, you make a note, you look back in time and go, gosh, 3 months ago, I only had $2,000. Now I have $4,000. Look at the progress I'm making in such a short period of time, because that's going to fuel you to keep going. Exactly the same as I said with the credit card debt, track and monitor your progress so you see and feel good and excited about what you're doing, and it will inspire you to keep going. And the same with the $1,000 project when it comes to investing. Look at your portfolio, look at how much you've invested over a short period of time. And then the seventh step when it comes to using the $1,000 project for maximum efficiency and success. And that is to use the $1,000 project to evolve with you, your lifestyle, your situation, and your goals and dreams. So for example, say you use the $1,000 project to pay off your credit card debt. The moment that credit card debt is paid off, keep using your newfound habits and hacks to build a next $1,000 and achieve another more exciting, more responsible financial goal, such as building emergency savings so that you never get back into credit card debt again and run the risk of repeating history. Let the $1,000 project evolve with you and strengthen your own financial knowledge, literacy, and habit system. I promise you, the $1,000 project never comes with any regrets. In fact, you'll probably regret that you didn't do it earlier. All right, everyone, I really hope that you're feeling inspired and motivated to do the $1,000 project for yourself. Don't forget, you can grab a copy of the $1,000 project if you want to see exactly how I did it, the highs and lows, and more efficiency hacks and strategies for doing the $1,000 project. It really does make a huge difference when it comes to achieving your own financial goals and dreams. All right, everyone, ciao for now and enjoy.